What's this one? £500 for picking out the six most attractive skirts. Let's see, that pleated one's quite nice. And there's this pencil one. Yes, I like pencil skirts. Yes, they get me going a bit. That's it then, first B. And the pleated one, D. I think the tartan one next. Something very racy about it. I think it's the sporran that does it. Then the one with a slit up the side. Don't altogether hold with slits up the side. Too sensual for my liking. Still, we mustn't be too much of a fuddy-duddy. We must keep up with the times, however much we dislike them. B then. Then C and E, I think. That's it, sixpence staked. A, Hancock, 23, railway cuttings, Cheam. Place in order the six best-looking photographs of Jimmy Edwards. None of them much good here, are they? Still, if you haven't got the clay, you can't make the pot. D, B, A, F, C, that'll do. Well, then. Write in 40 words why you take the Daily Bugle and win half a dozen sweet shops.
Haven't you done enough of these for 1 week?
No. I've got another 58 papers and magazines down here I haven't even started on yet. And all with jolly good competitions in them, too.
Oh, what a waste of money this is. Ever since you read about the bloke who makes his living entering newspaper competitions, you've gone raving mad. That's all you do, competitions. Competitions! I'm sick and tired of the word, competitions.
There's nothing wrong in going in for competitions.
There is when you give up a perfectly good job to devote all of time to it.
It was not a perfectly good job that I gave up.
It was. The best job you ever had. East Cheam, Borough Council, Road Sweeping Division. As good as a civil service. Security, a pension, lots of fresh air. And you were due for a promotion. They were going to make you captain of the broom.
Never. Fred Harris had that job. And what a crawler he is. Sold his soul to get that job. He only swept up outside the town hall. Nauseating to watch him it was, sweeping round the mayor's car all day long in that sickly smile and the touch of the bush hat when he came out. Not for me, mate, I've got my pride. Guys, I can make far more money doing these competitions than I ever could with the council.
All right, then. How much have you won so far?
Six bucks? Well, no. Not much, I grant you. There's plenty of time. I've only just started.
Just started? You've been doing this for six solid months. 196 competitions a week. Plus crosswords, football pools and the Irish sweep. It's costing you 25 nicker a week for postal orders and stamps. And how much have you won?
Six bob. And a year's subscription to a magazine.
Which packed up the week after you won it.
I've told you the tide will turn, Sid. All I need is one big win and I'm set for the year. You must admit I've been very close. You look at last week. If I live to be 100, I will never agree that Lady Docker looked better in the V-neck sweater than she did in the polo-neck goalkeeper's jersey with the dolman sleeves. What I'm fighting against, these judges have got no sartorial taste whatsoever. Still, one has to keep struggling on. Win as much coal as you can shovel in 3 days. Just write in not more than 20 words how you would solve the problems facing the world today. Better leave that one. That'll probably take me 20 minutes or half an hour, that will. Now then. Ah, this is more like it. Pick out 20 pieces of music from the attached list that, in your opinion, would make the best balance program for a brass band on Clacton Pier.
Come in.
Hancock?
Yes.
Your morning papers.
Put them on the table, eh?
They are. Nationals on the top, provincials in the middle, foreign ones on the bottom.
Thank you very much.
Are you starting a fish shop or something?
Don't be cheeky. Hop it, otherwise you won't get your Christmas box.
Oh, dear, break me up, that will. I remember last year. Riches beyond the dreams of avarice, you said. Tuppence. And even then, old ugly here followed me out. Said unless I gave it him, he'd let me tires down.
You want to do me a favor, son?
Yeah, yeah.
Get out of it!
The right house this is. I think I'll drop all the papers in the mud tomorrow.
You dare. You touch that competition page and I'll wrap your bicycle round your neck.
Conkers.
Ah, get out of it. Get out of it.
I don't know what's come over this younger generation. There's too much of this lucky Jim attitude. Too much of this wanted something for nothing. Everybody's out for themselves. Nobody's worried about the country. Nobody wants to get her back on the feet again. Nobody will buckle down and do a hard day's work. Easy money, that's all they're interested in. What do you think the Arsenal will do this week?
Draw.
Yes, that's what I thought. Perm, any 8 from 43, 4 lines, 8 pence. Cross in the corner, I don't want any publicity. Never mind. Get too many begging letters. If they're anything like the ones I send out, I don't want to know.
Are you going to do all these?
Yes, this is my job now, Sydney. I'm a professional competition enterer.
Oh, no.
What now?
There's one here from Japan, the Tokyo Times.
Oh, show me. Yes, they're very interesting, these are.
How do you know? It's in Japanese.
I've got a dictionary. Anyway, it's obvious what you've got to do. A child can see that. Ooh, it's hard, though, this one. Out of the above pictures, you've got to sort out which are the expensive British products and which are the cheap Japanese ones. That's very difficult.
Well, what's the prize?
2 bowls of rice each day for the rest of your life.
And what good's that to you?
Well, there's one here somewhere for an evaporated milk contest. If I win that, I can set up as a rice pudding merchant. Satisfied?
I'll be satisfied when you give this up and go back to the road sweeping. I'm getting the dead needle to this. Look at the money you're slinging away on this every week, and where's it coming from? That's what I want to know.
I know that's what you want to know, matey. Ever since you found out I've got a bit of money tucked away, your fingers haven't stopped twitching. Look at them going there like a bunch of water diviner's sticks. I know what goes on here at night time. I've heard you creeping you down stick. I'll take a run at that. I've heard you creeping downstairs with your blow lamp and your jemmy.
I don't want your money. I just don't like to see you waste it, that's all.
I'm not wasting it. Don't you realise if I win these competitions, I shall have £900,000, 3 racehorses, 2 pubs, a grocer's shop, 6 assorted cars, 10 television sets, and a night out with Jane Mansfield.
And 2 bowls of rice.
And 2 bowls of rice. Well, you can make your own choice. Chacun a son goût. I'm going to make a fortune and post these. Good luck to you.
Now, let him please himself. If he wants to ruin himself, let him. I'm not interested. I'm going to stick to the decent, respectable ways of making a living. Not it. Adding it.
Afternoon, postman. Come to empty the box.
I have.
Oh, well, there's no need to put these through. They can go straight in the sack.
They can't.
They can't?
No. You see, my job is collecting letters from the pillar box. I'm not allowed to put any letters in my sack that haven't passed through the slit.
Yes, well, I mean, you can stretch a point. I mean, that's a waste of time. They've got to go in the sack anyway.
I'm sorry. Letters cannot be considered as having been posted until they have passed through the slit.
Oh, this is bureaucracy gone mad. Come on, man, this is the Elizabethan age, the age of spirit and adventure. Go on, be a devil, let's put them straight in the sack.
Certainly not. It's against all rules and regulations. Now, stand on one side, if you please.
May I carry on now?
You may.
Thank you.
Right. 4:15, last collection finished.
But I got another 200 letters to post.
I'm sorry, next collection, 8 o'clock tomorrow morning.
But that's no good, they've got to be there by tomorrow morning.
It's no concern of mine.
Open that door.
No.
I demand that you take my letters.
You're too late. Now stand on one side, please.
I'm not going without my letters, you take my letters.
Do you realise what you're doing? You are obstructing a postman in the execution of his duty. You are upholding and obstructing Her Majesty's mail.
Whatever you said, I am not.
All right.
Are you going to take my letters or are you not?
I am not.
Very well, then.
Give me back those keys.
Not unless you collect my letters. There. You don't take them, I shall drop them in the box.
Those keys are government property.
Not a step further.
Very well. I'll collect your letters.
That's better, then.
Now then. Can I have my keys, please?
Certainly.
Well, come on, open the door.
I can't. You've got the keys.
I'll get a fishing rod, then.
It's against all rules and regulations hanging fishing rods through government keels and things.
Well, put your hand in and get it out.
And get it stuck like yours, I should kill you.
Oh, this is ridiculous. Ridiculous. There.
Thank you.
Oh, come on now, you've got the keys. Open the door.
I'm sorry, I should be late collecting the other boxes, which is against all rules and regulations. Speed and promptness is the motto of the GPO, you know. Good day.
Come back here. I can't wait till tomorrow's collection. I demand you release me. Come back.
Hello, hello.
Good evening, officer. It's a lovely evening.
And what are you doing to that pillar box?
Oh, just leaning, you know, leaning.
And you always lean with your hand inside the box?
No, I...
Now, are you Irish?
No, of course I'm not.
What are you trying to put in that box in?
Nothing.
I see. Then you must be trying to get something out.
Isn't that brilliant? You're wasted on this beat, really, aren't you? You ought to be down at Doc Green. Of course I'm trying to get something out of me hand.
A likely story. You were hoping this box would be full up so that you could scoop a few out of the top.
I was not. There's nothing in there.
Oh, so you've had a feel around then.
But I can explain. I was trying to post some letters.
You know, I think you'd better come along with me.
Certainly. Will you carry this or will I? I don't know what they do to them at Hendon. I don't really. As you can see, I've got it stuck, haven't I?
Well, if I'm going to take you in, I suppose I'd better help you to get it unstuck, hadn't I?
Well, that's one way of solving it, yes.
Yes. Yeah, well, that's what I think I'll do.
Thank you.
Right. Now then, try it.
Yep. All right, wait a minute. Oh! Ah, thank you very much indeed.
Not at all. Well, now.
Hello, hello. Are you Irish? Yeah, I'll be moving along then.
No, wait a minute. You can't go away and leave me like this.
It's all right. I passed the fire station on my way home. I'll send a fireman down.
Oh, thank you very much, sir.
Yes, not at all. Good day.
Good day, sir.
You still doing those stupid competitions?
No, I'm not. I'm writing a letter. Now, just listen to this. Dear Ernie, you've never met me, but I bought some of your premium bonds once, and I noticed that once again my numbers have not been included in this month's prize winners. Have I done anything to offend you? Because if I have, I can only say that...
All right, okay.
Say that I apologise and hope you will forgive me. Regards to all at Lytham St. Anne's. Hoping this finds you as it leaves me. A. Hancock, Esquire.
All right.
What?
There's a bloke out here to see you.
Has he got a helmet on?
No.
All right, send him in.
Here you come in, I'm sure I've got to see you.
Mr. Hancock?
Yes.
Mr. Anthony Hancock?
Yes.
Congratulations, Mr. Hancock.
Oh, thank you very much. Who are you?
Who am I, he says. I'm Big Trees Pools.
How do you do, Mr. Pools? Big Trees Pools, the football pools.
That's right.
Don't tell me my four aways have come up.
Yes, four aways, 10 points, 3 draws, 8 results, and the treble chance. You've won the lot, and it gives me great pleasure to present you with a cheque for £350,000, 3 shillings and 11p. Perkins, the cheque. Oh, he's gone rigid. Get some water.
That won't do no good. Here, give me the check. Wave it under his nose. Wake up, Hancock. The loot, boy. Look, you've won.
I won. I'm rich. £350,000, 3 shins and 11p.
Yes. Now, I know a man like yourself, suddenly coming into wealth, might be at a loss to know what to do with it. So our highly trained advisors will be at your disposal for the next few weeks to help you sort everything out.
Yeah, don't you worry about it. I happen to be Mr. Hancock's financial advisor, bailiff, and administrator. Just leave it all to me. Now, thank you very much for calling. Ta-da.
Oh, but we want to take some photographs for publicity.
You put your cross in the square. He doesn't want none. Ta-da.
Just before you go, have something with me. Just a little drink for the you and the lads, eh?
3 and 11. Thank you very much.
Well, son, we're rich.
Don't like the way the word we is creeping into this conversation.
You don't mean to tell me that you are going to forget your dear old friend who stood by you and gave you all this encouragement during all those lean weeks? Who gave you arsenal to draw?
That was for next week. Now, look, Sydney.
Mr. Anthony Hancock.
We're not buying anything, thank you. It soon gets round, isn't it?
I'm from the magazine Tittle Tattle. Mr. Hancock, you'll be pleased to know that you picked out correctly the 6 best-looking photographs of Jimmy Edwards. Congratulations. You've won 2 pubs in Bournemouth.
Oh, drinks all round.
Naturally. Naturally, if you need any help in running them, we have a team.
Nah, you don't want to bother about that. I'm Mr. Hancock's financial advisor. Have you got the deeds?
Why, yes.
Thank you very much. Ted, it was nice to see you.
Kid, this is marvellous. Twice in one day. What am I going to do with it all?
Don't worry, kid. You leave all the details to me.
Mr. Hancock?
Yes?
I am from Daily Clarion. Your selection of tunes for the brass band contest on Clacton Pier was voted best received. Aye. You've won a block of flats and 50 long playing records of mass colliery brass bands of 1957.
Well, if we keep those, I think we'll have the block of flats there, but I don't think we'll bother about the records.
Don't be silly. We want the records. We turn them up nice and loud, get all the tenants out, put the rents up. You're lucky you got me, boy. Tell me, what else does he want?
Eh, nothing else.
Thank you very much. Ted,
I know, but...
Goodbye. Next.
Mr. Hancock?
What's the prize?
Oh, you knew. And it was going to be such a surprise, and now you've spoiled it all.
You're from the ladies' magazine, aren't you?
Yes. Ladies, Home and Beauty.
Yeah. What's he want?
4 dozen teacos, is it?
Stick them in the bedroom. Name?
Daily Sentinel.
Prize?
Television, sir.
Stick it in the bedroom.
Yes,
Ted,
Sid, I can't believe it. All this wealth, me, just an ex-road sweeper.
Democracy, my boy, that's all. Now, sit down.
Yeah.
Now, make yourself comfortable. Now, look, Hancock, you're a very rich boy now. Now, you've got to be very careful, because there's a lot of sharks about.
I know.
And you know how simple you are? I mean, they take you for a ride as soon as look at you.
True.
So, you've got to protect yourself now, haven't you? Well, yes. The only way to do that is for you to put it all in my name and let me run it for you.
Wait a minute, how does that protect me?
Well, it stops you slinging it away on foolish and extravagant living. Each week, I will give you a salary.
Well, I'm not sure, Sid.
Well, what's the difference between me and a trust fund?
I wouldn't trust you with the kids' milk money. No, thank you. I'll keep the money in my own name.
All right, I'll tell you what we'll do. Look, we've got to look after this money, haven't we?
Mm-hmm.
Right. So we float you into a limited company with me as treasurer. I've got the forms here.
You whipped those up a bit smartish, didn't you?
I've had them ready ever since you started this lot, just in case. Sign here.
Wait a minute. Let's have a look at it first. Anthony Hancock Arts Limited. Directors Anthony Hancock, Sydney James. Treasurer, Sydney James. Secretary, Sydney James. Chairman, Sydney James. Sales manager, Sydney James. There's a lot of Sydney James here, isn't there?
Well, you're a busy man. You don't want to have to fiddle with all the donkey work. That's my job. It doesn't affect your position at all. What really matters is the distribution of shares. Down there.
Oh, yes, share distribution. Anthony Hancock, director, 40 shares. Sydney James, director, 20 shares.
See? You got more than I have.
Yes, but wait a minute. What happened to the other 40 shares?
Oh, I had to distribute those among the secretary, the chairman, the sales manager, and the treasurer.
Oh, well, that's fair enough, yes. Wait a minute, they're all you.
Well, you can't expect me to do all those jobs for nothing.
No, that would be ungrateful of me, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
No, I must pay my way the same as anybody else.
Exactly.
So when you boil it all down, looking at it all round, I've got 40 shares and you've got 60 shares.
Yeah, but that's on paper. But then I'm doing all the work, remember?
Yes, I know, it's my money.
Well, 40% of it is. The other 60%'s mine.
Yeah. Well, how is it I only get 40% then?
Oh, blimey, look, boy. You're not doing anything for it, are you? I mean, here am I, flogging myself out, losing my voice, knocking myself to pieces, and there you are lying back, doing nothing, living a life of luxury and collecting a cool 40%. I'm being very generous, boy.
I hadn't looked at it like that. You're quite right, of course. Very lucky man sitting back making all this money. I feel I'm taking advantage of you, sir.
No, don't worry about it.
No, I don't want you to think I'm sponging on you.
Don't be silly. It never crossed my mind.
No. It's very nice, you see. I couldn't accept it. I'm sorry I should feel a parasite. I insist on you having another 10 shares, boy.
Oh, I wouldn't take them. I wouldn't take them, boy. I mean, you're a mate of mine. If I can't help you, then I wouldn't be much good, would I?
Sid, you're a white man. When they made you, they threw away the mold. I mean it. Certainly. Sid, I wish you'd have those other 10 shares. It's not right.
All right, then. If it makes you feel any better, I'll take them.
Good. I shall sleep better tonight.
Yeah?
Thank you very much.
And there.
There. Well, glad to be in business with you, partner. Come in.
A Railway
cutting's cheap. I down for pull out. Beans and milk. This is not right, not for a man of my means. I seem to remember I was doing better than this before I won all this lot. I suppose Sid knows what he's doing.
Morning, Hancock. See my gold watch anywhere?
What, like the ones you've been distributing to your family?
Yeah, that's the one.
No, I haven't seen it. Perhaps it's up in the drawer with your diamond typing and your ruby inlaid cufflink.
Yeah, well, never mind. I'll get myself another one. I've been thinking of buying the oak diamond and having a watch set in that.
Why not? Wouldn't be vulgar, would it? Sid, I insist on speaking to you.
All right, sir, make it quick.
You remember that £900,000 I won?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I want two bob of it. I'm hungry.
Hancock, we've been all over this before, boy. It's all tied up.
I know it is, in little bags in your bedroom.
Well, you can't have any.
I'm hungry.
What about the two bowls of rice every day?
I'm fed up with rice. I've had it with milk, without milk, with sugar, without sugar, hot, cold, fried, boiled, casserole. Got an inside like a paddy field. All I want is a meal, Sid.
I'm sorry, the funds won't run to it. Now, look, son, I know what you're thinking, and you're dead wrong, believe me. That's all different for me, you see. I mean, I am your personal representative. I have to go out and entertain all these people. I've got to impress all these business contacts. You don't seriously think I like living it up like this, do you? I'm doing it for you, boy, to further your interests. I'm doing it so that you can live a life of luxury afterwards. All right, then, if you don't like it that way, I'll tell you what. You have all the gear. You have the motor cars, the gold watches. Go on, you go out and entertain all the customers.
All right, then.
You stay where you are. You want me? I'll be down at the Silver Grill at the Dorchester.
And if you want me, I'll be in the soup kitchen at the British restaurant. Rio de Janeiro, Friday. Dear Hancock, having a marvellous time. Wish you were here. Business deals going well, firm making large profit. Yours, Sid. Well, it's no good, Polly. We've hung out as long as we can. It's you for the pawn shop, mate. Everything else we've got is round there, and after you, it'll be me. Don't look at me like that. It's not my fault. Soon as Sid comes back, I'll have you out, because he's making a lot of money for us, you see. I'll have you restuffed. You'd like that, wouldn't you? Hey? The old beak polished up a bit, eh? Because I'm a millionaire, really. It's just that I haven't got any money. Come in.
Mr. Hancock?
Yes?
Good news, sir. I'm from the magazine Picture Parade. I'm sorry we're late for the news, but you won first prize in our last month's competition.
You mean suggest a new husband for Rita Hayworth?
Yes, sir. And you'd be pleased to know that she's thinking of accepting your suggestion.
I've won first prize.
Yes, sir.
What is first prize?
A night out with Jane Mansfield.
Jane Mansfield? Me? Jane Mansfield and me?
Yes, sir.
With my beauty and her brains, what a team. Who's paying for it?
You are, of course, sir.
Well, I say, that's a bit off, isn't it?
Well, good heavens, you can't expect us to do everything, sir. I mean, after all, we're supplying Jane Mansfield.
Yes, I know, but it takes money to take her out, and I'm broke, you see, it's all gone. Don't somehow think her taste will run to a hot meat pie stuck to a cold plate with a dollop of chopped sauce. You'd come a fortnight ago, it was all right. I was a millionaire then, but now...
My dear fellow, Miss Mansfield is a simple girl. A night out with her will only cost you £50.
You mean that men spend £50 to entertain her for an evening and she's simple? I haven't got that kind of money. I haven't got any kind of money.
Oh, surely you must have some somewhere.
Not a nibble.
Good heavens, man, this is the chance of a lifetime. A night out with Jane Mansfield. Think of it.
Control yourself, you man.
You can raise £50 somehow. You could mortgage the house.
Yes, that's a thought, isn't it? Get somebody else to put the rest to it. It's tempting. Of course, I've always fancied her, you know. I'd look better next to her than that weightlifting, Herbert. Because I got muscles, mate. I can lift weights. After all, I carry all this around with me all day.
You'll go then?
Yes, I will.
Thank you very much. Why not? Once in a lifetime.
That's more like it. 8 o'clock then, the Kismet restaurant, a table near the orchestra. Have a nice time.
Thank you very much. Jane Mansfield. Oh, for a man. Well, she's going to get one tonight. My last 50 quid, still it's worth going back on the embankment just for a night out with her. What shall I wear? What shall I wear? That's a laugh. All I've got is me conjurer's coat from the Masonic cabarets. Look at that. Look at that lovely colour there. Midnight green. I don't know. What attitude shall I take with her? Perhaps American, I think. Tough, the Robert Mitchum, I think. Hello, baby. I just won you in a competition, see? I don't want any trouble, see? I don't want this playing hard to get, see? Because this is going to be the greatest night you ever had in your life, see? Now she's heard all that rubbish before. Probably pour a bowl of minestrone over me head. No, I think the English way for her, yes. Hello, darling. Anyone for celery? That's no good. It's not me. No, she'll have to take me as I am. Raw, untamed. I'm going to enjoy myself tonight. I'm going to get my 50 quid's worth of it. It's the last thing I do. Good evening. My name is Hancock. I've reserved a table for two.
Oh, yes, the competition winner.
Yes, thank you.
Perhaps you'd like to order now. Your guest has already arrived.
Yes, I see. Well, I think I'll just have 50 quid's worth all round the menu. Better make it 40 quid's worth. I'll save a quid for the cab. You may lead on, my good man. Thank you. Hi, babe. I just won you in a contest. How about a big kiss, son? Huh? How about a kick this, baby?
Hello, Hancock.
All right, then go on. Tell me, what happened to Jane Mansfield?
Well, she couldn't come, so they asked me about
it. Did you hand in for her? Oh, no.
Well, you wanted a film star, you got one.
50 quid worth of food I've ordered.
Oh, that's nice, because I'm starving.
You starving? Where's all our money gone, then?
Oh, I lost all that in South America. But you've got nothing to worry about, boy. I have bought up every newspaper I got in South America, and I got some smashing competitions, eh? Look at, listen to this one. Choose the 10 best moustaches and win 100 sides of beef. How about this one? Name the 7 best revolutions. Boy, with your luck, I tell you, we'll clean up here. Now, what we do is float ourselves into a company, and the first thing that we do, with a bit of luck from you...
And not before time, I may add. May I have the captions, please?